While it's blowing an absolute storm outside, let's explore a fabulous pink diamante tool from AliExpress that is designed to heat fuse little diamante crystals onto fabrics. So this thing costs, and I'll provide a link in the description down below, but there's lots of sellers, but it's cheap. It's something like $6 for this tool. And it comes with various tips, and I'll put one in, I'll plug it in right now. So let's get this out. I can't be bothered actually trying to untwist that, so I'll just snip that. And I'll plug this in. I'll get the hoppy up, in fact. Well, the hoppy's little sibling, the anti. And I'll choose the bit that I'm going to use for this. I reckon let's go for the bigger crystals. So basically what we're getting with this, we've got loads of little cups. Let me show you this closer. We've got the options of cups like this, or we've got flat surfaces. And just there's a medley of them in the actual kit. And you screw in the desired one. I think it's roughly a 4mm thread. So let's choose this one. And we'll screw it into the end of the tool, and then we'll plug it in, and we'll do a couple of things. We shall see the power consumption of this tool when it, as it heats up. And also we'll then check the temperature that it goes up to. So here is the hoppy, the anti, to be precise. And I shall plug it in. It's currently turned off now. I shall put the plug in there, turn it on, and I'll just log the power draw. So initially it goes up to about 60 watts, 80 watts, and then it drops back down. So that suggests there's a PTC heat element in this. Power factor is 0.9, which is basically it's a heating load. And then the current is about 80 milliamps and dropping as it heats up. Right, tell you what, while it's heating up, we shall bring in the temperature probe. Let's use a standard thermocouple. I'll zoom back out for this now because it may be easier. I'm going to have to tilt this backwards. And it will stick a thermocouple into the end of this. And it's showing it's at about 72 degrees Celsius. 90, is it? Oh, no, hold on. Am I getting a decent connection here? It's over 100. We'll let it heat up. We'll let it continue to heat up. There was another little thing that came with this. A little stand that's designed to sit into, but I'm not sure what I've done with that. It was here somewhere, but now it is not here. Oh, there it is. It's a little, very simple stand. We put it like this, I guess. The power is stabilised at 10 watts. That's pretty good because it does say 10 to 12 watts, 100 to 240 volts, and that does suggest it is just PTC thermistor. Let's tilt this back the way and stuff the thermocouple into the end, see what it's showing. 150 degrees centigrade so far. Celsius even. And climbing, it goes up to a fair temperature. You could get a fairly big burn off this. I'll let it heat up a bit more. And in the meantime, I shall grab the diamante and a bit of fabric that we can test this with. Now, I have tried this. I tried it on a bit of paper, putting one of these crystals onto a bit of paper, and as soon as the hot melt glue in the back of it, it just skidded right across the paper. So that wasn't a great result, but that's okay, it's just because I don't know how to use it yet. So these are the crystals that came with it. They're a horrible sort of brown colour. I'm guessing they chose unpopular colours. And the crystals themselves have that hot melt glue sort of printed onto the back of it. So I'm going to put some onto this piece of fabric here. And this means I'm going to have to press directly down it. Let's check the temperature so far. Is it going to be 180? Is it going to be around 200-ish? Well, let's try and keep it out the way of the light so you can see. It's yo-yoing all over the place. That is going all over the place. So about 200 degrees Celsius, I think that's because I'm sticking a thermocouple with metals into another metal cup here. Okay, I may have to... Actually, you know what? I've got a better idea than this. I shall grab a soda iron tip temperature monitor. Here we go. Let's try it with this. So I shall simply place it onto... that bit there, and it says 220 degrees Celsius. That's quite spicy. That's going to hurt if you get it onto yourself. Okay, now, here's a tricky bit. I'm going to have to press vertically down this, so I'll do that right now, but I'll also show you one pressing sideways. So I'm pressing down vertically onto it, and I can see the hot melt glue just squished. It does actually spread the hot melt glue all out the side of it. It's visible. Right, tell you what, to show you this actually happening, I shall tilt it an angle. So I've got this in its thing. We are going to take this apart, obviously. So I'll pop another crystal out. And I shall find something I can use that's not going to get damaged. Oh, let's use that. We'll use this little block of paper here. And I'll place this on like this. Put the diamante on, zoom down onto focus onto that. And then I shall attempt to show you this by putting it on like that. And hopefully you'll see it's not very bright. Oh, you can see that the thing is skidding about and the glue is squishing out the side. I don't know if you can see that. But suffice to say, it has squished the glue, and once that's cooled down, I'd guess the diamante is locked in place. Right, tell you what, I'm going to let this cool down now, and then we'll take it apart. I'll pause while that happens. One moment, please. The device has cooled down to an acceptable temperature, so it's time to take it apart. Now, I'm trying to work out how this came apart. There is a silicone sleeve over here, designed as a sort of, like, easy grip here, and I was wondering how they get it on if they pull it over the top of this. And then I discovered that if you twist this, with the worry that you're basically just about to scrunge all the wiring out of it, this comes off. It's got a fairly coarse thread, and then theoretically this bit should just slide off. It does. There is clearly a screw under here, so we'll get that label off. Will I need any tools? No, it's off. It's off crudely, that's fine. And we'll take these screws out. Not expecting a huge amount, but I'm wondering how they put the PTC heating element into the actual tip here. We'll find out when I open it. Maybe we'll find out if there's anything visible. Okay. So we have probably just a resistor, and here's the LED, and the PTC heater. Hold on. Is it just stuffed down the end of that? Oh, it's right up at the tip. Okay. That's kind of pressed in, I think. I don't think this is going to come off any further. But they've basically got the heating element just stuffed in there. Can I get that open? Is there anything visible here? Oh, I can actually kind of see. Down that threaded section, I can see inside that, and it does look as though the heating element is just pushed right into the end of it. I don't know if this is going to come out. I shall use pliers. If it doesn't come out, it's going to end up destructive, so I think we can more or less guess what's in it. It's like a mini hot melt glue gun heater, which is the ceramic heater with the... Well, I think it is. Well, it is a PTC heater, so it's going to be the ceramic one. Oh, this is going to mess this up, isn't it? How have they put this together? Oh, that's not coming out. That has been pressed in with force. Right, tell you what, I'm just going to pause momentarily and try and see if I can see much up the end of this. One moment, please. Yeah, that is not coming out. It is jammed in absolutely solid. I think they've friction fitted it and just pressed it in. And it's not coming out without the risk of destroying the thing completely. But looking down the end, I can see that the tip where all the action is involved, this is basically just a little carrier tube down here. But it looks as though it's got a rectangular cutout in it with the PTC heater block, which is the little ceramic rectangular block, like that. And it usually has a little electrode plate placed on each side. And then it's wrapped in Kapton tape. Do you have confidence in the idea of this? I mean, it's what they use in hot melt glue guns, but the Kapton tape is the main insulation between the heating element and the metal barrel here. But it looks as though it's pushed in there, and that's ultimately, it means that if you look down the end of this, you can see the Kapton tape. So I wouldn't recommend screwing anything really long into this, make sure you only screw in the correct inserts, because otherwise you could actually go right into the electrics. As far as the little indicator LED goes, there is a brown, red, yellow resistor here, and that is basically 120K is what it is, which means that resistor is going to get very hot in use, because it's being well grilled, well above its sort of rating. But that's it. I mean, it's fundamentally, it's a switch, it's an LED just as a indicator that it's on, and then the little PTC self-regulating heat element down there with the screw-in tips that are used just to melt the glue. Interesting enough device. Fun, I suppose, if you want to put diamantes on things. But maybe there's other uses. You know, maybe you could actually use it for putting in sort of heated inserts to press them into plastic or something like that. But an interesting little device. Very basic, very simple, very functional, and best of all, fairly cheap. Okay, let's finish the video properly and also mention that I've now discovered that what we call diamante in the UK is called rhinestones in America. Didn't know there was that cultural difference. So I have taken a grinder to this and I've made a big slot and it took a chunk out the PTC block at the same time. And the construction is very similar to what I was expecting, but slightly different and simpler and quite clever. We have the, well, I'll show you. I'll show you a picture of the bits first, and then I'll show you how it goes together. So if we take a close-up look at this, so I shall focus onto that and zoom in. What we have here is the PTC resistor, which is the slab of ceramic material, this piece of ceramic material here, with the electrodes just sandwiched on either side, and then it's wrapped in Kapton tape. And these are the two tabs that come off the electrodes onto the wires that then have little fiberglass sleeve slid over them. The electrical connection is made to these metal tabs onto either side of the ceramic. The end of the Kapton tape is crimped, and then the whole lot is shoved in here, and then it's pushed down into the tube. And in doing so, it basically just crushes it flat onto that slab of material. So fairly precise measurements. I don't think there's going to be a lot of giving it. And it's interesting to note that when you do have this sleeving in the end, I'll do it without the electrodes and I'll just shove it up the end. So I'll focus back up to about here and zoom up a little bit. When you do shove it in, it stops kind of well short of the end with that Kapton tape where it's actually crimped like that, which means that that much of the heating element is just sticking out the unit. I thought they would have gone for, you know, but they could have with less crimping, so to speak, they could have put it almost in the full length, but they do need a little bit of a crimp at the end to stop it shorting out in the end, particularly given you can poke things down the end, they do go into the electrical bits. That is more or less it. There's another thing worth mentioning. The resistor in here really is underrated. It must be for the 120 volt supply more than the 240. 120K is not high enough in series this LED because it will conduct in both halves of the waveform, even though it only lights in one half. And that means this is dissipating half a watt, and it got up to about 160 degrees Celsius looking at it through the thermal imaging camera. So if you had one of these, you could either basically disconnect the LED if you don't want this hot component inside, or you could upgrade it by changing it from 120K to 470K, depending on where you are in the world. 120K fine America, not on 200 and upward voltage supplies. But there we have it. The interesting little heating thing, I could see other uses for this. Particularly given basic was up to about 200 degrees Celsius and it can be used for pressing things with that little sort of, I'm guessing, M4 thread. I should check M4. I'll see if I've got an M4 screw and I'll try and put it in. One moment, please. And the answer, yes, M4 screws into this. In fact, you could screw it right in until it started crunching stuff. Oh, it kind of bottoms out before it reaches the point it's going to cause carnage. But so if you have a M4 threaded hardware, you could put it into this for heating things. But there we have it, the diamante or rhinestone heated insertion tool, and the way it works with its little PTC thermistor with its insulated sleeving put up there and then just stuffed into the end so that it just pinches it down and locks it in place. Very neat and simple assembly and very useful little device. You can think of other uses for that sort of controlled heat source. Quite neat.